feast of the Blessed Trinity, the Solemnity of the Trinity. Now, after the dynamic events of the Easter season, this might seem kind of strange. But today we are acknowledging a kind of a doctrine of the Church, a very fundamental doctrine, but nevertheless, a doctrine, not an event. And yet, I think you will find as we listen to the readings and the homily that this is more than simply the doctrine. The Trinity speaks to us of the very life that we live as Christians. And so as the Mass unfolds, hopefully you will enter into the mystery of the Trinity, not just as something aloof, far from us, but as something very close to us, the inner dynamic of our lives and of our relationships with one another. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Let us prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery by calling to mind ourselves. You came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father, Lord of mercy. You heal the wounds of sin and division, Christ have mercy. And you intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And now let us join together in a great prayer of praise. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. For you are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, to be extolled and highly exalted forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you who took into the depths from your throne on the chariot.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, to be sung and glorified forever.
Glory and praise forever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, put things in order. Listen to my appeal. Agree with one another. Live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints greet you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said to Nicodemus, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. The one who believes in him is not condemned, but the one who does not believe is condemned already for not having believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Example, and I believe his example has had quite an impact.
Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Blessed Trinity, three persons in one God, a picnic for theologians and those who enjoy the more intellectual side of the faith, but a fairly dry observance for many who prefer a more dynamic understanding of God. But take a look at the Gospel once again. Jesus said to Nicodemus, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Is this not the story of that courageous man interviewed on the news? The man who could identify with those people in the streets because he was one of them? By sending the Son into the world, was God not identifying with us and with our world? A world with so much goodness and potential, and yes, a world with so much sin and division. But God did not send the Son to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. All the great teachings of the Blessed Trinity can be boiled down to this, that God is for us, that God is with us, that God is among us, traveling with us as we seek to make God's kingdom on earth a reality. As God is for us, let us be for one another. People of peace, mending our ways and mending our communities and our world. Identifying with one another, carrying each other's burdens, rejoicing in a God who is saving the world through love. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Let us join together now in renewing our profession of faith as we say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. There he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Jesus opened up to us the wonderful mystery of the one God, a Trinity of persons. In the grace of the Holy Spirit and through Jesus Christ, we pray to the Heavenly Father.
That the Christian Church, in all its diversity, will be faithful to the worship of God, to the praise of God's holy name, and to the works of charity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
That, in the name of God, we will help one another, be united, and live in peace, so that we reflect that unity of our God, His Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That in those places which are affected by violent protests arising from racism, the inequality between the rich and the poor, and disaffection with the government and law enforcement, people will have the opportunity to receive justice, respect, and new opportunities. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have been baptized and have died in the name of the Trinity, along with all who have died in police custody around the world, may enter God's heavenly home, opened for us by the death and resurrection of Jesus. Lord, hear us. hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of this Mass, the people of the parish. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. Glory be to your name, O Father. Glory be to your salvation, O Son. Glory be to your wisdom, O Spirit. Glory be to you, one eternal God, now and forever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, and become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. For the mystery of this bread and wine, that we come to share in the divinity of Christ, humble himself to share. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you in the humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, Lord our God, this oblation of your service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit. So that, in confessing of the one true eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by the angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body of blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, our supper was ended. He took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior, in the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all the dead in this faith, you alone, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, God Almighty, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever. Now, longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, and peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. You may offer each other a sign of peace at home. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health, body and soul, as we confess your eternal, holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace, love, and serve the Lord. And thank you.